not, the strategic airstrike in Kundang aimed at Sadono was successful. Military intelligence, well, marks a dramatic reversal in U.S. and coalition efforts in Indonesia. General Kellner predicted a favorable resolution within. Even if Sadono has survived, he's dropped so completely from public view that hostage taken by Sadono from the U.S. Embassy to Dili is still unaccounted for.
Operation ShadowNet is coming together better than anyone could have expected. Sadono's insurance policy is as good as canceled.
So what are the Joint Chiefs suggesting we do with Sadono?
We take him alive. We learned with Nicolás how assassinated leaders tend to be stubborn ghosts.
Television 3 Indonesia, Jakarta, Indonesia, April 20th, 2006, 2143 hours. Capture Suhadi Sadono. Now that the NT-133 has been located, Sadono is open to attack. Coordinated remotely with ShadowNet's neutralization of the NT-133, locate and capture Suhadi Sadono. CIA operative Ingrid Carlson is on site. Undercover and will assist in the mission. Now, here's my question about all of this. How did Ingrid actually make it onto Sadono's roster? I mean, yeah, she is part of the CIA, but I think there's a little more to things than, you know, is being let on, especially by Ingrid. At any rate, greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Pandora Tomorrow in First Person Perspective. This is essentially what it all boils down to. This is what the entire, you know, efforts of Sam and the Third Echelon initiative of the NSA have been towards thus far. Basically, Suhadi Sadono decided to attack the U.S. Embassy to Dili in Eastern Timor. Turns out, upon further investigation, that there were plans of his to actually wage war against the country and in order to stop U.S. Intervention. Stop a counterattack. He essentially bought some, how do I put this, biological agents, weaponized smallpox from a black market in Syria, which he intended to release on the US should he ever be caught or killed in action. Now that by the end of the previous video we have completely neutralized that threat, you guys actually saw how that happened in the cinematic for this level itself, for this mission itself. We are now free to target Sadono. However, like Lamba said, we are not supposed to kill him because that will just martyr him. So what we want to do instead is capture him. And that's what we are going to do. So, yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and begin this level. Now, everything does look pretty in the first-person perspective, but the thing is, I don't exactly know how this level is going to go. Let me see if there is any data to be read. No, of course there isn't. Anyway, let me just go ahead and adjust the sensitivity of my mouse here. Better. So anyway, we're not going to talk to her because we did that the last time around. Yeah, I don't really know how this level is going to go. I've never played it in first-person.
You need to infiltrate the TV station first. This is where Ingrid and Sadono are.
Hopefully I'm going to be able to do this level properly. I'm going to be using save slots this time around so that it's just easier for me to, you know, do this without jeopardizing the mission, basically. Right, so first save slot would be here. And from here on out, I'm going to be safe scumming using the quick save feature. But typically what I would want to do is step out into the light there. But since I do not know what's on the other side, I'm just going to step over onto here.
Hey, is that your bike over there?
Yeah. Why?
I think I blew my carburetor.
Tough luck.
Yeah. Do you have an Allen wrench I could borrow?
Let me check my bike. Just a second.
Strange. Quite strange indeed. Anyway, from here we can essentially pick off some of these targets from the looks of it. Conveniently, this light is also off so that it makes infiltration easy for us. This guy we can pick off right here. I don't know whether we are supposed to kill them or not, because these two seem to be just civilians. This guy's just a civilian, he's nothing more. I don't think I want to harm him. Our targets are all the way over there. If they are even targets. Infiltrate this TV station. Lethal attacks are permitted. That doesn't mean I should, but might as well. Let's find out.
Here. Thanks, man. Shouldn't take me more than a few minutes.
Keep it. I've got another, and I need to get out of this weather.
Hey, thanks a lot. I owe you a beer.
I'll take you up on that someday.
I wonder if people in Indonesia actually owe each other stuff like this guy sort of insinuated right now. I think somebody bumped into the body over there. Well, if I'm gonna play stealthily, it doesn't really matter if I have this mod installed or not. Might as well play it like a proper first person shooter. Or rather, third person shooter. A stealth shooter, the way it's meant to be played. The body, I don't think, has been discovered thus far. That, there's a guy patrolling over there. I don't know if that's... that seems to be the civilian over there. Now, it is a stealth shooter in the end. So I don't think I want to just go all out with attacking these people. But, with that being said, I think there were supposed to be two people here. Not that I can see the other person, but yeah, there were supposed to be two people here, I think. That guy's in the light. I can't exactly touch him, per se. I can, however, take that light out. Which enables me to... oh, almost fell there. Climb out. And... yeah... approach the problem from this angle. Now, there are multiple complications in this area. For example, that stranger walking about. Might as well pick this body up and put it somewhere safe and away from view. I'm just gonna let the stranger pass before I make a move. Okay. What you doing wrong? Is it a spy on me? Another dead body.
Security stage increased. Stage 1. Flak jackets on.
Alarm stage 1. Sam, don't be detected.
Fisher, you are paid to be invisible.
Security stage increased. Stage 2. Helmet on.
Alarm stage 2. Fisher, if you remain a ghost, the alarm stage will decrease.
Roger, roger.
The situation will soon be out of control.
What if I say no? What if I say no to helping you out? What you gonna do then? That guy's a civilian, I'm not gonna do anything to that guy. But as for the rest, I do believe they are in sufficient enough of a shadow to where people are not going to be able to discover them. That's two alarms already. I better be careful for the next section. I wonder if there's like an alternate path through any of this. And I can see this thing here. I can't pick the lock. Might as well go in and see what it's all about now. Since there are no more people to discover me at this point. One of the things that I've never really properly done is explore this game. Might as well make a quick save here. But these people came from somewhere around here.
What is that? Is somebody coming?
Who knows? Maybe they are. Yeah, I don't think there's any other way through this place except for that one part that we took. Like, we have to take. So, these are just some of the ways that the Australia is just far better. And giving you an option for, you know, playing it the way you want to play it. Since I have two alarms already, and I do remember getting detected here. I don't know why, but I somehow got detected here before. Since that is a thing that happens, I'm just gonna play it safe and not there. Come on. Come on, Sam. You can jump on this. Good job. Oh, wait. I think there is a way to come here. Via some other means. Ah, I see. Through the shop here. Interesting. Yeah, there's even a health pack here. Time to refill our health. And hopefully, by the time we get back into, like, get to the next section, the alarms will have disappeared. I can only hope. And I mean before the sewer section, that is.
Patir, go ahead. Penyuk says your boys aren't wearing their headgear. That's right, sir. Night vision's not safe with the lightning. Flash-blinded snipers would be useless to you. So how are we covering the parking lot? We've got extra men down there. It should be fine.
It should be fine indeed. Yeah, we need to be more careful targeting these guys. Might as well use sticky shockers on them, that's it. Or, we could go ahead and use a smoke grenade. That we just recently acquired. It's a real pity we can't... Wait, did one van go in there through the gate? What just happened?
No, he's fine, I'm sure. He looked confident.
Something's moving!
That's good. Yeah, these guys seem to be in the shadows. Let's get that satchel from him. And you know what, I'm just gonna make another save here. Probably should have saved before, but oh well. So what I'm not gonna do right now is walk down this path, because there's a turret right here which is going to start firing at us as soon as it detects us. So what we're gonna do instead is climb over this fence. There's a broken section of fence right here. Right here. Which we need to climb over. Let me take out all these legs as well. Just to make it nice and dark.
Security stage decreased. Security stage back to normal.
Okay, it seems they've gone back to normal.
For now. That just means that I can shoot them all I want to. Now then.
Sam, don't be detected.
Anybody
Fisher,
else?
You are paid to be invisible.
So I've heard. So I have heard. I guess there are no more people here. So another question is, do I need to take out these lights then? I cannot take this light out, might as well move this guy to the shadows. Because otherwise it's gonna cause like a string of alarms for every single individual that is not hidden.
that the game works in this manner, but that's just how the game works, so can't really do much about it. Take out this light, take out this light, hopefully these guys are in the shadows, take out this light as well, just in case. This guy seems to be in the shadows, I wonder how the other guy heard him. But yeah, they're both in the shadows. Anyway, this is the way down, like our way forward. I'm gonna save here. So, that is our way forward. Bad news is, it has a guard there. Good news is, there are no blinding lights. Bad news is, there are lots of folks here. Keep patrolling the entire area. Saving again here. Thankfully, this game has a system where the alarms keep getting reset every now and then.
Security.
Oh yeah, I completely forgot about this part. Where there's literally a camera here, watching your every move. We can take it out, to be honest. Even though it might just prompt another person to come out here and investigate, that's still better than, you know, just leaving the camera on like that. There's another locked door here which we cannot access. I'll just let that guy come out and shoot him. Since after all this, we are playing like a stealth shooter mod. Come on. It pains me to admit that I require a zoom from this close, but well, the accuracy in this game isn't exactly the best. Bullets don't always hit dead center. As you guys can probably see, they do tend to miss from time to time. And when they miss, well, you're in a world of trouble.
Security stage decreased. Security stage back to normal.
Okay, it seems they've gone back to normal.
So the security stages increase and decrease at, like, weird intervals in this game. Very weird intervals. I don't know what's up with that, but it is just the way it is. Ah, this section. Now, I always wondered whether I can, like, just take the sniper out instead.
Sniper position confirmed.
Just move there. So as soon as we come out here, we are in the safe zone, but there are landmines all around us, so we need to be careful. And I don't know where the sniper is, to be honest. But that's just one of the things that I wish to figure out. I could probably go here, I don't think the light will be able to reach me from there. And I do believe I can take him out as well. From here itself. And I do believe that's the light taken care of. Time for these spotlights, if I can manage that. I guess not. I'm gonna make it safe here. So yeah, despite there not being a sniper anymore, we still have to exercise caution. We can't exactly just run out into the excuse me. Right. I am crouching, but sometimes I tend to feel like I'm not doing that. Just because of, you know, the view of the camera in this mod. So there's one right there. I don't think the light should be able to spot me here. It is not. Quick saving. Just for good measure. Now, where's the next one? One is right in front of me. I'll let the pass and light pass over me again. I feel like this is... I can comfortably go this far. Even further, actually. The light won't be able to see me. It's like a really poor arrangement of... Well, the lights on their part.
Security stage increased. Stage one, flak jackets on.
Alarm stage one. Sam, don't be detected.
I'm Fisher, trying.
You need to be a ghost. You're putting the mission in danger.
I don't know why they could see me like that. Loading the gun here. Now, this would have been the prime opportunity to move, but yeah, I guess we're safe. We don't need to time it that well either. So, last stretch. We just need to get all the way over there. Because, I mean, we could try climbing over this side as well, but it's sort of like there is a lack of barbed wire over there, but I do believe it's safer to go all the way over to the other side instead. So, this beeline in this general direction. I'm gonna wait here until that light goes back. Or rather, at least starts heading back. I don't mind the single alarm, to be honest. And since that one takes time coming over, I'm just gonna head and start climbing. And that's good. That's good. Saving here again. Swatch roll so that these searchlights can't see you. And, well, the searchlights don't come all the way here, so we're golden right now. I don't know why or who spotted what, but something happened. I think it's just that bug that is usual for this level we're in. The people on the other side of this wall, they more or less just spot you. So, and yeah, they come to investigate. Like, if I just stand here, I don't know if they're gonna come now, but they do tend to come in and come over and investigate, so, yeah. Anyway, I'm just gonna pick this up.
Fisher, if you remain a ghost, the alarm stage will decrease.
Fisher, we cannot afford any more casualties. One more alarm and the mission is over.
So good. Oh, apparently they didn't get 4 rounds here. This guy was just standing here and chilling. I sort of feel bad for killing him, but yeah. We essentially had to take the long way around, come all the way over here, just to cross this second bridge. We essentially had to take a right just to get this building, but we went all the way in the down the sewer, up into the satellite array of the broadcasting station, and through the back to come here. And we also have a flare here, that is nice, even though it's like more or less useless right now. Because, okay, somebody was found. Oh, it was this guy. How do I put this guy in the shadows? I hope that guy's not in the shadows. Like, in the light. That would be unfortunate. Just one of the things that I dislike about this game is the fact that...
Cohen was right to mistrust Miss Carlson. There's a reason for that warm smell under the wall. She's an honest-to-God agent. A lot more than that hapless desk jockey she was playing.
That makes sense, if a bit far. Fetch that she just happened to be in the right place to luck her way into being one of Sedona's hostages.
She was at the embassy looking for Salt. The agency needed to know whether or not he was still a viable asset.
I guess they got their answer.
Yeah, I can't sneak past this thing to deactivate that turret. I need to be able to do that so that I can get to that other body over there, which seems to be in... Well, this thing is dropped right here. He is hoping that does the trick and puts that guy in the shadows. Seems to be the case, but yeah, I guess we'll never know. Just one of the few issues with the third person mod, you never really know where you are headed, so to speak. So there's this guy down there that we need to be just a little careful of. Question is, how did he not hear us shoot through this window?
Until the American people have felt the sting of the terror the rest of the world bears for the sake of their affluence. Nothing can shake my faith that Indonesia is not alone. There are others in the world who will stand beside us, who will take the battle back into the home of the aggressors, as I stand here now unharmed, despite the best efforts of this world's so-called... cannot extinguish the will of the whole world. Indonesia is not alone. And as long as they insist on threatening her sovereignty, America is not safe. The world will soon understand. Good night.
Security stage decreased. Security stage back to normal.
Okay, it seems they've gone back to normal.
Gone back to normal just before the...
And now you need to find Carlson. Sedono's keeping her around as a translator and bargaining chip, but she can move through the station with relative freedom. We're hoping she can quietly get you close enough to Sedono to grab him alive. Sedono needs to be caught by surprise.
Yeah, that last part is true, because if we try to force the action, he'll just run away. And that guy hits like a harder than a sniper. So we really need to be careful when dealing with Sedono. So this guy vacates the premises and he does not come back, so we don't really need to bother about him. We just open this door and walk on through. Now the next few sections are a few of the sections that I'm wondering about how to play strategically, if that would be the right word for it. Oh, I need to be facing the other way, I guess. Yeah. The mechanics of the wall jump are a little bit, well, difficult to put things in a manner of speaking. I'm just gonna put my legs up so that these guys don't hear me, you know, walking all the way over to the other side. One of the things that I miss in the news and the titles is how things are very slow and deliberate in these older games. Really? Did you guys really see anything moving? Or was it just the shadows? I think we're at the end here. Luckily we can still shoot people. But it'll have to be in this tiny little frame here. I can only see a guy that I would love to shoot, but unfortunately I can't exactly shoot him. You're right about that, probably nothing. Not just probably, it is nothing.
Security stage increased. Stage 1, black jackets on.
Alarm stage 1. Sam, don't be detected.
Fisher, you are paid to be invisible.
I'll keep that in mind. I will keep that in mind, Lambert. I think that's all of them. Yeah, the music seems to indicate so. That's just a body. Should I quick save here? I feel like I hear a camera, but I don't know if that is true or not. Like, if there are any cameras here, I can't tell. This body's in the shadows. This body is in the shadows, and it has a satchel for me. So I'll just keep it right here. I hear somebody moving about. Anyway, let's go over to just a data stick. Sort trigger ND133 now. Get this to sort trigger the ND133 now. Leak from a red beard contact says, "We're screwed. Scrambling to load armed guardian services on my end." Yeah, I can't really read most of that. I'll take the risk and save you. I can hear somebody moving about, definitely, but these guys are in the shadows. I don't think there will be any kind of an issue. There was supposed to be a guy there, I think. Yeah, right there. He just...
How much longer will this take?
20 minutes, at least. I told you my Hebrew's only passable.
Sedano's waiting for it.
I'm doing the best I can. Where did this come from?
You know I can't tell you that.
There's something in here about the angel's X. I'm putting a note next to it that I don't know the translation. You might want to point that out to Suhadi.
Sure, sure. Just hurry up.
Yeah, before I do anything to this guy, and something needs to be done about this guy because he's just literally sitting there, maybe we can just blow his brains out, you know? No need to be so fancy. No, you're not. Stop lying.
Security stage increased. Stage 2. Helmet on.
Alarm stage 2. Fisher, if you remain a ghost, the alarm stage will decrease.
Fisher, the situation will soon be out of control.
I literally shot this guy through the noggin. How? Did I miss? It was supposed to be a goddamn through and through. Anyway. Huh. Just shenanigans, I guess. I mean, nobody's coming to his aid, so I suppose I'm fine. Anyway, all restrictions are gonna be off the next section onwards. And I don't think anybody else is going to notice me walking into the store here. But before I go there, I just want to quickly check out what this store has to offer. Surveillance room, I see. And it has some 556 for me. Amazing. I hadn't been using this gun in a long time, but I can see myself using it now. Ingrid.
Hello, Ingrid.
You? I didn't think it would be you.
You knew somebody was coming?
I've managed a few brief exchanges with the agency, enough to know I need to get you close to Sedano.
Can you do that?
Yeah. There's a retinal scanner on the studio I've been authorized for.
You made yourself friendly fast.
Sure, Sedano's a sucker for a smiling woman. Would have been a different story if Soph were around. We've hired a chopper to pull Sedano out. If you can get him outside, we can get him back to the States.
Ingrid's a godsend.
I keep pinching myself.
Play along. Trail her to the warehouse. It's our best and only way to get at Sedano.
So I hope. Quick saving here. And while these guys have their backs turned to
us. Hello, Ingrid.
Excuse me. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know why that guy ended up following his pre-programmed patrol pattern again. He's not supposed to do that. But anyway, since we have this opening right here, might as well go ahead and exploit it. There's this one guy that we need to take out. Grab him, drag him to the shadows and just drown him. Nobody will know that he was ever here.
Security stage decreased. Security stage back to normal.
Okay, it seems they've gone back to normal.
Right, so this isn't good. Is she not coming? Ah, there she is. I guess she's marked as friendly. Right, I'm gonna keep this thing equipped right now. Maybe even pull out some smoke grenades.
Up ahead, I'm going in the right-hand tunnel. You'll have to take the left-hand path. I might get slowed down with the guard, so wait for me on the other side.
We just intercepted a call from Soft. He blew Ms. Carlson's cover.
Yosodono knows she's CIA. Any one of these guerrillas might gun her down. Don't let that happen.
Yeah, that sucked. That honestly sucked. I could have done far better than that. So one thing that I've noticed about this game is the fact that, well, yeah, that did not go as anticipated, that just fell down somewhere. Okay, it's never gonna be retrieved. Do these guys have night vision on? I did not check properly. Apparently they do not. I think not. Anyway, before we talk to her, let me just go ahead and take these lights out. This guy had the night vision on. This guy had one on too. I wonder why it's not on their heads. Should have stayed in the light in that case. And I have no idea if the grenades fell, they just disappeared somewhere. I hope I don't miss him just accidentally hit Ingrid here. I think everybody's in the shadows. I suppose so, yes. Miss Ingrid. Why is the game bugging out? Ingrid, come on! You need to get going. Come on, get a move on.
Hey, it's my guardian angel. Thanks.
Are you alright?
Still breathing. Here, I'll open the door.
Once I have Sedona, where do I meet you?
The roof. Not the most subtle option in the world, but we're not using a military chopper. So hopefully we'll have the chance to slip by.
Let us hope so. I'm just going here to double check again whether these guys are indeed in the shadows or not. They seem to be in the shadows, so I think it would in that regard. Funny how this did not incur an alarm of sorts. So this is it. This is the extent to which we will be following Ingrid.
I need technicians! I need batteries! I need men in the studio now! Sedano's taping immediately!
I know your local intercept grabbed that, but you need to hightail it to the recording studio.
I'm getting a glut of side chatter about escape routes.
The studio's likely to be your last chance to grab Sedano. If he gets out, he'll either vanish or be killed. Neither of which we can afford.
Roger that. So, we're gonna have to use a camera jammer. Stand up.
There's something over there!
There's nothing over here. You need not bother yourself.
Security stage increased. Stage 1, contact is on.
Alarm stage 1, Sam. Detected.
Fisher, you are paid to be invisible.
Be invisible. I'm gonna get caught again. On camera. Luckily, there are only two bodies here, so yeah. Like two people that we need to worry about. And a health thing. That guy saw me coming over. Otherwise, I would have been just fine and dandy. I think we can just keep him here. At most, it'll just incur an alarm, and I think we're fine apart from that. Now, why I say that is because, well, the last section we can't really afford to go in guns blazing anyway. We're gonna have to be really stealthy about it. Which I don't know how it's gonna fare with this mod, to be honest. At any rate, this is a way up. We grab onto this pipe and we come out of the other end. Hi Sam. Look at them arms. Look at them guns. So this is where this level is going to get difficult. So yeah, I tried jumping over this thing here, but I suppose they have designed it in such a manner that it cannot be done. Which leaves us with the only option of being able to go the long way around, because otherwise this mission would have been very easy. Now, we can see Sadono all the way from here, but the problem right now is the fact that we can't exactly reach him from this side. He's inclined more towards the other side. That curtain is longer, so we can easily grab him if we rush to him from this curtain onwards. But this side, nah, it's not going to be that easy to do it. And plus, until unless we start heading there, he doesn't exactly start his speech off either. So that is the problem.
Sound, speed, and we're rolling.
Citizens of the world, I am alive and well, and closer than you think. It has been 10 days since the date claimed to be that of my death by the U.S. government. It has been a week since the regrettably necessary release of the smallpox virus on U.S. land. I hope that by suffering, the people of America understand a little bit of the suffering that the rest of the world must endure for the sake of America.
I don't know why this section is here. I wonder if you can, like, get it. Oh, okay. I can't exactly use that retinal scanner, of course. My eyes aren't really configured for that.
And cut. Good. What do you think?
I'm not sure I should have called smallpox regrettable.
Do you want to do it again, or a third version without mentioning the pox?
No, I don't have time. It will do. Ready, my men. We are leaving.
No, you're not. I must nab you before you leave. I cannot let you leave.
Don't shoot! We can't take the risk of killing Sadono!
Damn right you can't. Yeah, it's unwise.
Leave him now and you're dead.
Gun out like that. Because
leave him now and you're dead.
That is true. Now here's the thing. It's sort of unwise to pull your gun out like that, because if you do that...
God! God!
Where's the retinal scanner? Oh, by the way.
God! God!
Yeah, this guy's just gonna keep shouting God, God all the time. And somehow, despite the fact that we have a back tune to them, they're not really going to... I just want to try something real quickly. Yeah, so basically you need to be a little careful with the movement of these guys. I tried shooting them, but they open fire back at you.
Great work, Fisher. You're well on track to becoming history's most prolific unknown author of world events.
If I had any blood left, I'm sure I'd be blushing. Is Ingrid in position on the roof?
That's right. And the helicopter, too. Keep Sadono conscious until you've made visual contact with Carlson.
Can I get a confirmation, Fisher? Sedano's alive and you've got him?
Yes.
Fantastic. Don't worry about leaving a mess behind you on your way out. We're arranging to sweep up after you're gone.
We're not in the clear yet. Get Sadono to the roof. Ingrid's waiting.
Anyway, this fella starts shooting around the field right now. They don't really expect to hit anything. This you want to shoot. That's all.
Here, I would have gift wrapped him, but I couldn't find any duct tape.
It always shocks me how young he looks. Like a little kid compared to his face on television.
You honestly liked him?
No. Respect, maybe. But I know he's a monster. He has a child's idea of war. Can't tell the difference between a citizen and a soldier. He thinks the whole world is a morally viable target.
There's only one nation on the planet fighting the whole world.
Huh. Whose side are you on?
You know I can't say that.
Yeah, I know. I don't know who you are or how you do what you do, but thank you. I hope we can work together again.
All right, then, that's that. Whenever you've got holding somebody hostage like this, if you make a mistake of turning your back to them, they will shoot you. Even if some of the bullets just end up hitting your hostage, they will shoot you. And in this game, they're not doing it, but in the first game, if you ever drew your gun out to shoot a soldier while you're holding somebody hostage, they will gun you down without hesitation, because I suppose it's because, I don't know whether it's like fear and a reaction in self-defense, or whether it's just, you know, they realize the fact that you're no longer threatening the actual hostage. But yeah, they shoot you down. They're not doing that in this game. Anyway, television-free Indonesia, Jakarta, Indonesia, April 20th, 2006, 23:05 hours. Mission complete. Suhadi's capture essentially brings a crisis in Indonesia to a close. Shadow teams neutralized all of the NT-133, but one glaring exception. The one that Suhadi instructed Soth to take out. CIA-trained mercenary Norman Soth is somewhere in the US with the final remaining Pox Box. So Sadono essentially told Soth to just release the vaccines. Oh, not the vaccine, sorry. Release the virus. We're doomed. And Soth, being the prompt actor that he is, complied. Now, that's just, even though we already have Soth, we need to neutralize that last remaining Pox Box to essentially tie up a loose end. So anyway, that is the story for the next video. When we come back, we will be tracking down Soth and attempting to disarm the last box of smallpox, weaponized smallpox viruses. But as for today's video, this is it. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow things.